फ्रॉम स्क्रैच यूजिंग विक्स सॉफ्टवेयर, हाउ टू क्रिएट कोर्स एंड सीसी लाइसेंसिंग. सेम वे वी विल प्रोसीड फॉर क्यू एंड ए सेशन. क्वेरी सेशन वी विल टेक योर क्वेरीज एंड योर फीडबैक एज वेल फ्रॉम 2:30 to 3 PM टुमारो. देन वी विल प्रोसीड टुवर्ड्स द फाइनल क्विज. सो ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैव टू अटेम्प्ट दिस क्विज विच कंसिस्ट बेसिकली 20 questions फ्रॉम ऑल दीज टेक्निकल सेशंस, ऑल दीज टेक्निकल कोर सेशंस. सो 20 question वुड बी देयर, ऑल वुड बी एमसीक्यू बेस्ड एंड ऑल ऑफ अस आर रिक्वायर्ड टू अटेम्प्ट द क्विज टू गेट योर सर्टिफिकेट्स एंड द मटीरियल एज वेल. ऑल द मटीरियल्स विल बी शेयर्ड, द रिकॉर्डिंग PPT, PDF, everything will be shared, I guess within a week or so. Okay. So, these were the outcome of the session one, agenda for this session. After this session, you would be able to create your classroom using Google Classroom software. From scratch, we are going to do it. How to create a class, particular class, then how to add participants to it, whether students or co-teachers, how to post material or how to post the announcement, make announcement, how to share your material, then how to create assignments as well as quizzes. Quizzes would be auto-graded and manually graded as well. So with the rubrics and without rubrics, both of the way we are going to do it. We are going to say it, and how we can conduct live classes as well using another tool offered by Google that is also free, Google Meet. We can use to conduct live classes, and those recording we can share with our student using Google Classroom, that is the LMS. So given a context, I would prefer to start it this way. As all of us are thrown into the situation where we didn't have any idea what is going to come after during the lockdown period, after the lockdown was imposed during March. So I request all the participants to please mute yourself. Please put yourself on mute mode. Thank you. Thanks a lot. So classes were shut, the colleges were shut. Students were at home and we were at home, and we were asked to do a lot of things which we had no clue or no idea about. Though we have learned a couple of times probably how to record a video, how to share it with our students, how to work with the flipped classroom and all those things, we did all these things by experimenting by ourselves because we were not left with any other option. Nothing was so very regular to us because we had that physical connect with the students. We were used to take classes in a physical classroom. That face-to-face interaction was there. And all of sudden, everything changed overnight. So when we missed that physical connect with the students, we ultimately went into the situation, or you can say the zone, where probably this is what that has come for us. We were forced to switch from offline teaching to online teaching. I believe that most of the participant will agree or will be agreed to me that yes, we have underwent a lot of trouble due to this pandemic situation. We were not prepared for this situation at all. This graph shows the same situation we were gone through. Kubler-Ross was is a, actually a psych actress who have throw some light on maximum social issues, and this is one of the change. This is one of the issue that he has says about the change curve. As human being, we have the tendency to not to accept the change. Although we all are aware that change is constant, and I believe that all of us somewhere down the line were thrown into this particular zone from offline teaching to online teaching. Initially, if we are forced to do something all of sudden, then we go into the shock situation. It's very surprising for us to accept the change. We try to deny it. looking for the evidence that it's not going to be true. Soon the situation will be under control and we will have the regular classes or the regular situation as it was before. But as the time passes, it leads to frustration in us. As a human being, this is the tendency that we don't accept the change very frequently. We resist to changes. So it leads to depression as well. So after this lockdown period, when we were supposed to switch from online teaching to, sorry, offline teaching to online teaching, we thought that we were not aware of the tools and techniques, what tools we should use and how we can convey our content delivery we can do online. We were not aware of all those things. So it leads to depression. After some time, what we have gone through, we thought that things are not going to be changed until we change it itself. We just have to adapt the change. Then we start experimenting with the things that how we can cope up with the situation. So we just start experimenting. Then we learn some tools after viewing the YouTube or internet. Then we came up with some decision that yes, this tool can be used. This is the good one. These are the good features. And we can use with our classroom, all those things, we come up with decision. And right now we are in the phase to integrate those tools and to practically apply that knowledge in our classroom. I think that all of us would be agree to this this change curve, what we have underwent actually. So these were the challenges faced by teacher during online teaching. We were not very good at digital skill set. We were having lack of resources. Suppose in a family, we all are having, most of us are having kids. So they were also having online classes. Schools were closed. So we are not having the enough resources to deliver the content and all those things. We were not familiar of this mode of teaching online. We had to rethink and replan the course from offline to online mode. There was no clarity what tools and technologies to be used. So we were struggling to find the right tool. We were doing the R&D, experimenting by ourselves that using which tool we can record our lecture, by which tool we can make our presentation more powerful, how to convey our message, whether it's any LMS or WhatsApp group. We just stayed connected with the students. So today in this session, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to share my knowledge, what I have explored during this 4 months. Google Classroom, I find it very user-friendly, very easy to use for beginners specifically. As like our physical classroom, we can maintain the same classroom using online. Google provide a good number of tools which we can use for free. Absolutely free. We are not required to pay even a single penny for any of the tools. It is freely available, and out of them, one is Google Classroom. We are going to discuss this tool in this session. So I request my fellow participants to please, I want you people to have some hands-on practice along with this session. So if it possible for you, so I request you all to turn your laptop on so that you can do as I am doing, or I am presenting my screen, so you can do as I instruct you to do, so that you can have the hands-on practice side by side this session. So let us start the demo of Google Classroom. First, we need to open the browser. Specifically, if you want, then you can use the Google Chrome. It is a product of Google itself. So what you have to type, you just have to type classroom.google.com. This is the one way to open the Google Classroom. Another way, I'll tell later. So please open the browser and type googleclassroom.google.com. It will ask you to log in. You are required to have Gmail ID, specific Gmail ID, to start with Google Classroom. As it is a product of Google, so you have to have Gmail ID. Your Yahoo ID, Hotmail, or Rediff Mail won't work. I'm sorry to say this. Your Hotmail, Rediff Mail, Yahoo ID won't work here. You just have to have Gmail ID. to work with Google Classroom. So I have made this ID specifically for this workshop. So I am logging in. You are required to put the password. You just have to log in and it will land you to this page. Here we are not having any class. So this is your Google Classroom dashboard, you can say. I'm going to create a class. What you have to do as a teacher, make a note. As a teacher, you just have to click plus symbol, plus button, and then you have to click create class to create the class. I'm creating a class here. You just have to agree the terms and condition. Click continue. It will ask you to create a class. Suppose I am creating a class for you people. So this workshop is about Tele 2.0. Teaching learning digitally redefined. Section, there is no need to give. Subject, let me see, online tools. Room, there is no need to give. If you want, then you can, but it's not mandatory. Okay, so I'll create a class. It is taking some time. Okay, so this is the dashboard or the user interface of Google Classroom after creating the class. You can see your classes, how many classes you are having just by clicking this tab. This is three lines. You just have to click it. This is the main menu actually. So here you will get the classes option. You just have to click over it. And now you will have all the classes you have created as a teacher or as a student you have joined. You will have all the classes over here. I have just created this class Tele 2.0 with zero students because as of now I don't have any student. I just have created the class. So I request you, all the participants, I request to join this class. How you can join the class? Let me tell you. This is the class code. Please note it down. TIKE5HL. All is in small case. TIKE5HL. What you are required to do is same thing you have to do. You just have to log in with Google Classroom. Let me show you what you have to do. Just type classroom.google.com. It will take me to the same page because I have already logged in. I just have to log in with another ID to show you that how it will look at student end. So I just have to sign in with different ID. It will ask. So, webinar 1234. Okay, so this is the student page and this is the teacher page. From this ID I have logged as a student and this ID I have logged as a teacher. Okay, good number of students. Four students already joined. They must be aware of Google Classroom and might be they are using it. Okay, that is good. So what you have to do is you just have to log in with your Gmail ID and click this plus symbol. And you have to click on join the class because for this particular class, this Tele 2.0 class, you are joining as a student. So you have to click join the class. And what you are supposed to do, you just have to copy or you just have to write this code. I'm just copying it. You just have to write the code and then click join. By this way, you are able to join the class. Yes, now I have joined the class. So as a teacher, I can see how many students are there in my class by clicking this people tab. See this many, 8 students already have joined the class. I request all of you to join the class, please. I expect at least 50% of participants to join the class. I'll demonstrate both ways, as the teacher point of view and as the student point of view as well. How it will look like from student dashboard and how it will look like. Okay, Varanasi ma'am, hi ma'am, class going smoothly, thank you. This is the way you can post comments over here. I'll explain how to do it. Please join the class. 10 students have joined the class by now. Okay, so in the meantime, I should explain all these features. Classes, I have already explained that in classes feature, now this I am accessing the faculty, the teacher classroom. F for faculty, teacher classroom. Please don't get confused with the two classrooms. This is for student, S for student and F for faculty. All right, so this is how I can see all my classes I can see here. Right, so 12 students are there in my class right now, they have joined it. Okay, so from here, this is basic interface, you can say the user interface of Google Classroom. Here you will see four ribbon, or you can say four tabs: stream, classroom, people and grades. In stream section, this is basically for your post. Hi, okay, two class comments. Hello. So what I'll do here, I'll post a message for you guys. Welcome, dear participants, to this 2 days workshop. Suppose I'm posting this message, whatever I need to post, whether announcement or whatever, it will be reflected in stream section. This page, it will be reflected. All the activity will be reflected here, right? So I'm just posting this message to all the students. Now you would be able to see this change would be reflected at your, let me show, at student end how it will look. See, from your end, it will be looking like this. FDP workshop is my name. I have joined this workshop, or I have created the ID with this name. So it will be reflected by this name only. So I have posted this message. This message will be posted to all the students, because I have chosen all student. All student, we have option. We can choose. We have all the students here. If we want to send specific message, then we can check and uncheck from here also. All right, which if we have multiple classes, then we can choose from here also. All the classes would be here. Right now, there is one class, so there is no need to choose. Okay, so this is how this stream will look like. All the messages, all the announcement, all the posts, the study material, your video lectures, whatever the post you are sharing will be reflected in this section, the stream section. All the comments, everything will be get displayed here. So let us check how many. 13 students have joined the class. So I think it's a good number. We should proceed. Okay, next tab is the classwork. In classwork section, this is the most important tab, you can say, for this Google Classroom, for a teacher basically. We will get all the option available here. If we want to create an assignment, if we want to create a quiz, if we want to post a question, if we want to share the material in the form of video lecture or PDF or PPT or link, or share it with Drive, Google Drive, all would be done with using this material tab or material option. We can reuse our post with other classes as well. Topic, we can create a topic, or we can bifurcate our topic unit wise, subject wise, topic wise, then subtopic wise. Let us start with topic itself. Suppose I want to design a course unit wise. I am teaching a course, and that is divided into four parts, four units. So first I'll create unit. So first I'll create unit one. And then I'll post the material unit wise. See, unit one is created. Then I'll again make another unit, that is unit 2. This is how we can add n number of units. I'll create 2 only. Okay, then I think I should proceed towards assignment. How we can create assignment? As we are doing in physical classroom, we were circulating the assignments to the student, and they were supposed to submit it in hard form. Here we are going to do everything paperless. how we can do it, you just have to click on assignment tab, give a title. Suppose I am giving assignment number 1. Where is number 1? If you want to give some instruction, you can post instruction here. All questions.
Clicking classwork, nothing is coming.
Hello?
The proceeding very fast. Clicking classroom, nothing is coming.
Okay, sir. Okay, okay. Sorry, I'll go slow. So, stream is okay, sir? Or do I need to repeat it again? Hello, are you comfortable with stream, sir?
Stream is okay.
Okay, so classwork. All right. So, actually, for teacher point of view, this is the section where we will do all our work, whether to post assignment, whether to conduct a quiz, whether to create topics, topic wise, subtopic wise, everything as a teacher we will do from here. Okay, so I'll explain how to add a topic. Topic is nothing but basically you are dividing the units, you are dividing the topics. So I'll add one more, unit 3. And you just have to click over add and it will be added here. You will get to know when I post an assignment under some section like unit 2 and unit 3, then you will have better idea that what is the purpose of this unit. You can post the material under the unit. Under unit 1, you will post some subtopics like 10 topics you have posted under unit 1, then 10 or 12 topics you post under unit 2 and unit 3 and so on. So units are nothing, but you can divide the sections. All right. So I think I should proceed towards assignment creation, edit assignment. Okay, all questions are mandatory. Please submit your assignment before due date. Okay, whatever instruction you want to give, you can mention here. Now you have two tabs, or you can say two buttons. This is add tab. Here you will get four options: Google Drive, link, file, and YouTube. Google Drive, this is also one of the tool available for us, freely available for us. We can share or we can post or we can save our material. Up to 15 GB storage is available. That is for free. For a normal Gmail account, we can save our material in Google Drive. If we have saved assignment in Google Drive, then we can directly link from Google Drive and attach the link over here. Same, you can generate the link from Google Drive and paste the link over here. Copy that link from the drive or somewhere else and just paste the link over here. This is the another way. File, suppose any document file or any Excel sheet or whatever the file you are having, you want your student to view it and then turn in assignment, then you can add it as a file. If you want to add some some link of YouTube lecture, then you can post link or you can connect the link from YouTube as well. I request all of you to explore all these. I'm just going to explain one, that is file, because if I'm going to explain all the features and all the things, then it will take so much time and I won't be able to finish it. We are short of time already, so I won't be able to finish it. So what I am going to do, I just upload one file, what I have already created as name assignment, open, and this file will get attached with this post. See, there are options. Student can edit file, make a copy of each student, or student can view file. I want that student can only view this file and and won't be able to edit it. So I'll select this option. Okay, in create tab, you can create from scratch your own assignments in the form of document, slide, sheet, drawing form. These are all tools that is available by Google for free. All right, you can create your assignment from scratch using any of these. All right, then we have option to post this assignment. If we want to post this assignment to specific student, then we can check and uncheck. See, by default it will go to all student. So I want it to post to all student, so I'll keep it as same it is. And marks, suppose I'll give 10, you can make it ungraded also, but for assignment purpose we just have to mention some points. Due date, I want to give due date 8, so by 8:11:59 p.m. student can revert, student can turn in, or student can submit the assignment. See, here you will see the topics what I have created: unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, under which section you want to post this assignment. If you won't select any topic, then it will go under general section. Otherwise, if you want to be specific with the unit, then you have to select the unit. Suppose I want to be specific, then this assignment is related to unit 1. What topics I have covered in unit 1, this assignment is all about. So that is why I have chosen unit 1. And I just have to click assign. Assign. Now go to stream, and now you can see everything is available. This in stream page, you will see everything in chronological order. That means newest post would be at the top of the page. So recently I have posted this assignment, so that is why this assignment is there on the top of the page. Okay, you are requested to please turn in from student point of view. Let me show how it would be visible. See, from student point of view, it will be visible like this. Suppose I click, this is how it look like at student end. This is the assignment. You can post any comment. You can post this comment, whole class can see. If you comment in this section, whole class would be able to see it. If you post in private comments, only teacher would be able to see it. This would be the private comments. So how you have to complete or turn it, let me show you this also. You just have to click on assignment, whatever is posted. This is the assignment. What are the symptoms of COVID-19? Okay, you can't change or edit this document, as I have given the viewing rights only to the participants. So what you are required to do, you just have to click add or create. Then you can link your file. If you have created a Word document or a Word file or Notepad file and you have saved it in your local drive, then you have to link or that file with this. Suppose I'm doing this like this, upload. And you have to attach the file where you have saved the file. All right. And then you can turn in. This is one option. Second option is you can use all these tools in document form. Na? You just need to click Docs. It will take you to the I have blocked the pop-ups actually. It will take you to the document, and here you can answer or whatever you want to answer. Write it here, and then you just have to turn it. Okay, in Google Drive everything will be automatically saved. You need not to save it separately. Everything will be automatically saved in your Google Drive. The ID you are using, this ID, student online FTP, this content or this document will be saved in this drive with this ID. All right, so this is the another method you can turn in. Okay, and then you just have to click on turn in. So I request all the participants to please turn in, submit the assignment. I can see in under the grade section, you would be able to see that what assignment you have given to the student. This is the assignment you have given, and these students have got the assignment. Out of no, nobody have turned in. I haven't received any assignment by now. I request all the participant to please, just for demonstration purpose, I'm asking that. Let me turn in. Just for demonstration purpose, I am doing so. You can unsubmit also. If you have submitted the assignment and later you realize that you have made some mistake or you want to edit it, then you can unsubmit it and again submit it after editing. This option is also available. So let us see from teacher point of view that how many. See. Okay. Sampita ma'am have turned in. Suppose I just have to click view submission to see what the student has submitted. All right. Symptom of COVID-19, cough, cold, fever, breathing problem. All right. So you can grade the assignment from here. Suppose the student have answered the question correctly, then you can grade anything like 8, 10 according to you. And you just post a private, this comment is private comment. Whatever you are going to write it, it will be reflected to that particular student only. It won't be visible to the class. It will be visible by the student only. So suppose I'm writing excellent. Okay, and I'll post it. And I'll return it to the student. So, see. Are you able to see the changes? Here, I have checked the assignment. I have given grade 10 out of 10. This also, let me see. So you just have to click to grade the assignment. You just have to click these three dots. You will get two options, return or view submission. So click over view submission. No file attached. Madam, you haven't attached any file. Okay, for demo purpose you did so. All right. So this is how you can evaluate any assignment or grade any assignment. Right? And it will be reflected here. So under the grade section, you will see all the assignment, all the quizzes you have posted as a teacher, and the marks, how many turned in. See these number of students, Soumya and student FTP, that's me, then Varanasi. These students have turned in already. All right. So is it clear now? Should I proceed to quiz or do I need to repeat the same? Hello. I request participant to please reply.
Please repeat, madam.
Okay.
People section. What about the people section?
In people section, hello. We will have hello.
Yeah, audio. Hello, listening, ma'am.
Yeah, sir. I'm explaining the people section. Someone has asked about this. I'll take further queries in Q&A session. If there is any problem or if you want that I should repeat the assignment, then only please get back to me. Otherwise, I'll proceed. Okay, so first let me explain about the people section. From this tab, you can add co-teachers by sending them invite link. You have to have the email ID of your co-teacher. Suppose I am inviting Hema sir, brpeb.edu. And you just have to click invite. What it will do, it will send a mail to the teacher and for invitation to join the class. Then the teacher have to log in with the Gmail ID and will have to accept the invitation to be the part of this classroom. All right, this is how we can invite other teacher for the same class. And one way I have already told you that with sharing the class code, you can add student, or the student can join the class using the class code. There is another way also. Just click over this invite student tab and you have to type the email IDs. You just have to have the email ID of the students. Then you can send invite the same way I have invited teacher. This is the another way. In this option, actually, there is a problem with the class code. Suppose you have displayed this class code in your WhatsApp group, and somehow this code is revealed to other classes as well. So anyone can join. The person who is having the class code can join the class, right? There is no check. But for inviting purpose, you can specifically invite the student. It will send the mail to the specific student. They'll have the right whether they can decline or accept the invitation and can join the class. So these are the two methods you can join the class. Is it okay now? Am I clear about this people section? Okay. So should I
just begin now?
Okay,
yes,
so please. We should proceed towards quiz assignment. This was the assignment that we have to grade manually, right? We have to grade manually. We need to make an assignment in form of MCQs and questions, which is auto-graded. For that purpose, what we need to do is we just have to create a quiz. Suppose I am creating a quiz number one. This quiz consists in questions. This is just for demonstration purpose. I'm not going to use or going to create 10 questions. Just for instruction sake, I'm writing this. Whatever the instruction you want to give, you can mention here. Same thing you will have here also. If you have the link, you can use all those things. Otherwise, you can create a new one. Basically, we are going to use this blank quiz if you are going to make the quiz from scratch. So you just have to click blank quiz. It will take you to this Google form page. And this will be automatically saved in your Google Drive, right? You need not to save it. So this is the interface of Google Form. Let me explain a little bit about it first. This is the theme. You can change the appearance of your form by clicking this. You can choose image. There are good number of themes available. You can choose from. Suppose I'll choose this, insert. So it will change the look and feel of the form. So this is for just for cosmetic purpose only, theme. This is the preview. After creating the quiz, you can see how it looked like. And these are some of the settings we will cover later. So let us start the quiz first. What I want first, I just want to change the title, Tele 2.0 quiz. Okay. If you need to write some description, then you can mention here. Now, suppose I am mentioning, write your name, student name, they have to mention. These are the type of question that you can create using Google Forms. These are the type of question you can create. So name is must be in characters. So by default, it will take short answer type question, right? You want to make it mandatory field, that asterisk you must be knowing. So if you want to make it mandatory, then you have to click this toggle button. If you won't click it, it is not the mandatory field and student can skip answering this particular question. So if you want to make it mandatory, you just have to click this toggle button to make it required. All right. Then for next question, we have good number of options here. For next question, this is the add question symbol. You just have to click it to add next question. Next question, suppose I'm asking about the roll number of student. It must be a number. There is a check that Google form provide. It must be a number. If a student enter the alphanumeric character or alphabets, an error should be displayed. Please enter valid roll number. Right? I want to make this field as mandatory. Right? So next question I'll add. Suppose this time I'll take multiple choice question. Let us take which one is the input device. Suppose I have given this question, so I need to add options. First option is printer. Add another option. This be add option. Mouse. Next, plotter. And next option, suppose I'll give speaker. So this is how we can create a multiple choice question. This also I want to make mandatory. Now to make a quiz, I have to mention points. What marks this question carry? Suppose it will carry 2 points, and I just have to click the right option. This is the correct answer, and I just have to click done. See? So what it will do, it will make this form as a quiz after mentioning the point. See, here this point is also visible. So that is how you can create as many questions in the quiz and mark it and give some points to it, make it mandatory. All right. So there are other options also. You can, I'm just adding another one, another question. This time, suppose I'm taking a drop down. I think all of you are aware of all these things. Let me explain one by one. Short answer, like name, designation, all those things where you know that there are some characters only, then you can choose short answer type question. For paragraph, if you have asked something that need a paragraph, more than 100 or 200 words, then you have to choose this paragraph option. Multiple choice, I have already explained. Check boxes, you know, if you want that, if you want to include some question which have more than one answer, then you have to click check boxes type of question. Drop down, let me show you how. Suppose class, drop down option, you are giving BCA first year, add option, BCA second year, add option, and BCA third year. You want the student to choose from the number of options you have provided. So then you have to take question type as drop down, right? File upload would be there if you want that student should upload a file. Suppose you are collecting data from the student with their picture. Okay, so you want them to upload their pic. Then you have to take this question as file upload. And you have to give them right to upload file up to 2 MB, 10 MB like this. Right? What kind of upload you are allowing them? Is it a PDF file? Is it a PPT? Or just a JPEG or a PNG file? Just an image file? You just have to mention. For file upload, you will use this. Linear scale. Let me show this. Suppose we are rating. Oh, I have changed this only. Sorry. I just have to add another question and then I'll take linear scale. Suppose, how will you rate the material posted on Google Classroom? Suppose I'm taking feedback from the students that how you will rate the material. So one, poor, and fifth, excellent or very useful. So how it will, let me show you how it will look like. You just have to click on the I symbol, that is the preview button. This is how it will look like, see, to the students. See, this is the linear type question. All right, so it gets saved automatically. We need not to bother to save it, just close it. So what I am doing it, I'm just making this also mandatory, and all the questions are mandatory, so I just have to make it okay. And you can shift the question. You need not to worry about the question, the order you have put the questions. If you want to change the order, you are just required to click this six tabs or six dots, and you just have to drag it down and you are good to go. So this way you can change. So I am submitting. So what I am going to do is I just have to copy the link. What I did is I just click send button, click over link button. Here you will get the link. I want to shorten it. It's lengthy enough, so I'll shorten it. I'll copy it. Copy the URL. Okay, this is the one way. And I'll assign this quiz to the student. And second way, what I can do, I can post it directly to the stream as well in the announcement section. Here is a quiz for you. I can post it here also, that link. So these are the two ways post. Now I request you all to please submit. Please look into the quiz and attempt this quiz just for demo purpose. I'm just closing this tab, and this also. So I have, see, this is how it will look. I have clicked the assign button from the quiz tab now, so it will be reflected over here. And I have pasted the same link from the stream section and posted the link also. So both way I have taken care of. So you can post the quiz in both ways. You can assign it from there only, or you can paste the link and post it separately as announcement. So I request you all to please attempt the quiz. From grades, I'll get to know. See? Out of 100. Actually, I haven't changed the grades. The numbers, I haven't changed it. It will be auto-calculated. We need not to worry. From the assignment page, sir, you just have to click your dashboard. That is all. I just log in with the student account. Just a minute, I'll show you. This screen would be visible to you. In stream section, you would be able to see the quiz. See? Here is the link, and here is the quiz I have assigned to you. So either ways, you can answer, you can reply, or you can submit the quiz back.
From the assignment page to this page.
Mm-hmm. As teacher point of view or as student?
Student.
Student, I have explained you, sir. You just have to click over stream. Everything would be visible. Every post would be reflected here only. You would be able to see this quiz. You just have to click this and click over here, and you will be directed to the quiz. You just have to attempt the quiz and you just have to submit it. That is all you are required to do. Sorry. Is it clear, sir? Hello?
Madam, we are not going back from assignment page, madam.
As a teacher or as a student?
As a student, madam.
As a student, sir, you just have to click. See, are you able to see these three lines? Just click over it. And you just have to click the Tele 2.0.
Yes, madam.
It'll land.
Got it, madam. Got it.
Okay. So you will see the link of this quiz. You just have to click. over this link
yes,
or this post.
Yes, madam.
Okay.
Got it, madam. Got it.
Got it? Okay. So please attempt the quiz. Okay. Yes, I have received submission. No, I'm not able to see. Let me do it. It is visible. Suppose I am attempting Sonu roll number 1, 2, 3, 4 class I'll choose. Option 1 white is not reflected. I think there is some problem. It is not saved properly. Okay, let me try it again. Let me show it again. Is the same form is visible to you? Are you not able to see the options here? Suppose I click mouse and I
yes, I have submitted the form.
Okay, ma'am, your response have been, so you just have to click view score. Here you will be able to see your score, right? I have just given one question, one multiple choice question that I have given 2 marks. So I have submitted the question right, so I got 2 marks. So this is the screen you will get after submitting the quiz. This quiz will be auto graded. You need not to grade it because we have mentioned the marks already while designing the quiz itself. So this is how you can make a quiz, auto graded quiz. So let me see how many participants. Okay, for this I need to go to Google My Drive. I have to check the responses actually. No.
Well, posting the question, that response destination to be mentioned or not?
No, sir. You need not to mention the destination. It will be automatically saved in response. 6 out of 9, 6 have turned in. And one class comment is also there. Thanks, ma'am. Okay. So let me see how many of you have responded. So I have got 14 responses. You can check the responses from here. Okay, you just have to go to your drive and then you can check your responses. These many participants have responded. So I can check one by one. All right, individual I can check. So there are 3 tabs, summary, question and individual. I can check all the responses from here. Apart from this, I can extract the whole responses in a spreadsheet. What I need to do, I just have to click over this spreadsheet tab and it will create a new spreadsheet with all the responses recorded. See, with the timestamp at 11:03 a.m. Soumya has appeared for the quiz. Roll number, she has put this, all these things she has, and she got 2 marks. All the score I am having here with the timestamp. So this is how we can collect the quiz responses. Am I clear? You just have to refresh it to get to know that how many 14 responses are there. All right. So this is how we can create our quiz. One more thing I need to mention about the setting. With this tab, setting tab, you can change or you can limit the participant to attempt quiz only once. We are required our student to attempt the quiz only once. So we have to limit to one response. So we have to check this button. All right. And second thing, we can turn this toggle button on before giving the points. We have mentioned it in the Google form itself now. So that is why it is by default on. If we haven't mentioned the points there, then we have to first make it as a quiz and then we can proceed further to give points. So students would be able to, respondents would be able to see their missed question, correct answer and the point value. And one more thing, important thing it is, if you want to release the score immediately after the submission, as I did in this quiz, you were able to see the score, how many questions you have attempted and what marks or what score you have scored. So I have selected this immediately. By default, this option is selected. Otherwise, if you want to release the score later after manually review, then you can select this option. By default, this option is selected. All right, so this is for theme, this is for preview, and this is for the basic setting of the Google quiz. You can make changes from here itself. All right, am I clear? Should I proceed?
Madam. Yes, madam.
Okay, thank you. So next thing will be, question is just like a post, simple post. You just suppose I just want to ask you, how are you feeling today? How are you feeling today? So it's just like a simple post. There are only two type of questions, short one and the MCQ. So I'll choose MCQ. Suppose I am giving option awesome. I'm feeling awesome or good or not well. So number of options you can give. This is the important thing. Student can see class summary. If you check this button, whatever the other participants or other students are going to reply, it will be posted on the stream and it will be visible to all the student. If you want to restrict it to visible to this teacher only, then you have to uncheck this button. You have to uncheck this button. My dear participants, please make a note. If you want that other won't be able to see the answer or response of other students, then you have to uncheck this button. I'm checking this button and I'll ask this question. So this will be posted as a question on the stream. Let me show you. See? FTP workshop posted a question, how are you feeling today? So you can answer it. From student point of view, it'll look like, let me show you that also. See, it'll look like this. So you just have to answer. How are you feeling? All the option would be available here. You can click any and you just have to click turn in. Suppose I click awesome and I'll turn in. If I want to post a private comment, then I need to mention here. It will be visible to the teacher only. And if you want to post any comment to the class, then you can write it here. All right. So this is all about the question. Okay, let me go to the classes once again. 15 students have joined. All right. Okay, so this is all about the question. Let me check how many of you have replied. Okay, 9 turn in, 6 assign. All right. Okay, that is enough. Okay, so now we can proceed towards next section, that is our material. Yes, this is the material we are going to share with our students in the form of video lecture or PDF or PPT, whatever you want to share. Suppose I am posting some topic, like I am posting some material on cues. So what I have to do, I just have to, I'll have all the four options available from Google Drive, link, file, YouTube. Same option will be available with you. So what I did normally, I record a lecture using some screen recording software. I save it in my Google Drive and then I'll share that link with the students. So this is how I used to post the material, or I share the material with the student. Let me show you how I can post suppose a PPT or PDF with the students. Browse. Suppose this I'm going to share. This is just for demo purpose. See, I have attached this file, and in under what section I want to post it. Suppose this time I want to post it under section 2, unit 2, and it will be posted to all the student. I just have to click post. See, now please check in your stream that you will get this new material. FDP workshop posted a new material, cues. You just have to click it and you will see this PowerPoint presentation. You just have to click it and you will see this PowerPoint presentation. So this is how you can share material with your students. You can post study material, whether it in form of video lecture, PPT or PDF, whatever you want to share, you can share with this material tab. Is it okay? Should I proceed further, or do I need to repeat this material section again? Hello. I request participant to please reply. Otherwise, I won't be able to. Hello. Is it clear, sir? Proceed. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So next option is reuse post. I can reuse the same post with other class as well. Here we have just, I request you all to please mute yourself. Please mute yourself. Hello. I request participants.
Yeah, Hemra.
Mute yourself. Hema Kumar, sir. Please mute the participant. It's a lot of disturbance. Hello, madam. Hello. Please mute yourself.
Yeah, I'm muted.
Okay, thank you. Thanks a lot. So I can reuse the same post with other classes as well. These are the classes. These are archived actually. I have deleted those ones. So this is the only one class I am having. So if I have number of classes, then all the classes will be listed over here. I can share the same post with other class as well. So this is how I can share the same post. I need not to create the post again and again for other classes. I can share the post with other classes with this option. I can reuse the same post with other classes. So this is how we can create assignment, quiz assignment, question. We can share the material with the student. We can reuse the post and we can create the topic. Now I will touch one more topic, that is rubric. This is very important actually. In last assignment, we haven't mentioned any rule or any protocol or any standard on what basis I have to grade or I have graded the assignment. So for set of rules, I need to use the rubric. This is the beautiful feature available in this Google Classroom only, this LMS only, we can use. This is a very good thing. Let me show you how we can create our own rubric. The beauty of this rubric is students are able to see it, that on what basis they are going to grade, on what basis they are going to get their scores. So this is the beauty of the rubric. So first, it's like the set of rules or instructions student can go through before attempting for the assignment. For example, suppose I am creating this assignment. with rubric. Please, the instruction, what I want to give is, please read the instructions carefully before attempting the assignment. Right? Whatever instruction I want to give, I can give here. So here what I have to do, I just want to add that same file, that assignment, same question, same assignment I am going to post, but this time I am going to do with rubric. Last time I have graded it manually, this time I'll do it with the help of rubric, so that you will get to know that what is the difference between with rubric and without rubric. So what I have to do is, I just want to post it to all students. I'll make the points as 10. Due date I'll mention here as 8th of August. Time I'll mention 11:59 p.m. Under this time I'll take under this assignment under unit 3. Here we have to click it. From here we can create the rubric. There are three options available: create rubric, reuse rubric, or import from sheets. Create rubric means you are creating your own set of rules, your own rubric, okay, that you are going to share with the student for this particular assignment. Second option is reuse rubric, means you have already created a rubric and same is applicable for this assignment only. So you can use this option. All right, so you can reuse the rubric which you have created earlier. And the third option is you have created the rubric using Google Sheets and you can import that rubric with this assignment. So I'll explain how to create from scratch, how to create your own rubric. So what is the criteria title? What you want to give? Suppose the title I want to give is based on explanation, or criteria set of rules you are going to set. Suppose what points you are going to give, suppose 5. Level excellent. What would be the description? When the student will get the 5 marks? How the so if the student detailed explanation with all the valid points. If the student have mentioned all the valid points with detailed explanation, then he'll get the excellent score and 5 marks will be given. Suppose you will give 3 marks and good detailed suppose the very some explanation with few points. Okay, next one needs improvement, or you can say fair or poor, only points. Okay, so this is or if blank 0, not acceptable. Wrong answer. Okay, so this is how you can create a rubric. So you just have to create save. I'll show you one sample also. The rubric I have created. Okay, this is just for demo purpose. I'll assign it Now please check your stream for the latest update. You will be having this post, FTP workshop posted a new assignment, assignment with rubric. Please check. As a teacher, I can see that how many students I have assigned this assignment. 17 students have got this assignment. Till now, zero turn in. I request participants to please submit, please turn in the assignment so that I can tell you that how it can be evaluated with the help of rubric. I request participant to please turn in. Let me show you. Yes.
Some people are asking about the class code alone. Just can you show the class code again?
Okay, once? Yeah, sure. Please. This is the class code. TIKE5HL. All okay. Alphabets are in small case. TIKE. Sir, post this.
I posted it in chat.
Yeah.
Sure.
Put it
in chat. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay, I request all of you to please turn in this assignment with rubric so that I can show you that how it can be graded. Seventeen students have joined as of now. See, this is the beauty of this Google Classroom. All the grades would be available here. All the assignment detail, the quiz, whatever you have posted will be available here. You can see anytime. No one has turned in. I request participant to please turn in. Let me sign in from another account, student account. To show you how to turn in. This is student account. I got this assignment. Okay, so what I have to do, first I have to view the assignment, what is given to me. All right, then I can reply. Suppose I'm taking the same file, attaching the same file. It's just for demo purpose only. I just want to show that after turning in how you can grade the assignment. So I'll post the same assignment. This is how the student can respond. Okay, so I have made the answer of this assignment and I just have to click turn in. Turn in. I can post a private comment and class comment as well. All right, so now I'll see. I'll check. Okay. Some of them have already submitted. Okay, so this is the teacher user interface. From teacher, how I would judge or how I would grade the assignment. I just have to click the grades and then whosoever have turned in. See this madam have responded turn in. So how I can see rubric, whatever I have assigned is here. So on the basis of the answers, on the basis of these answers, I can assign marks. See, 5 point is for excellent, 3 point is for good, and 1 point is needs improvement, and 0 point for not acceptable at all. Suppose I am giving 5 point, excellent. See, this score will be automatically updated here. I need not to mention each and everybody the score, 2, 3, 5 marks. I just have created rubrics and I just have to click over here. Then I just have to give comments, private comments. Suppose I'll give excellent or good effort, keep it up. I'll post a private comment and I'll return. Now, can you see here in the grade section, the student record or marks have got updated. So this is how you can grade assignment with the help of rubrics. Last assignment we did without rubrics, and by this way you can create your own set of rules. Let me show you one sample also, which I have created for rubric purpose only. Number of criteria you can add. On what basis you are going to grade the students? What it actually depend on the assignment you are going to make, which type of question you have included in your assignment, and how it will be graded. So you can make your own set of rules. See, this was I have made for the, some project proposal. This was the criteria, and these were the grades, rating scales I have given. These were the criteria: identification of a problem, domain, and detailed analysis. So for excellent grade, the proposal should be detailed and extensive explanation of the purpose and need of the project. So if it is fulfilling this criteria, this scale, then it would be given excellent score. So like that, you can create your own rubrics and you can reuse them. This is just for sample purpose. So now I think I should
with the rubric page, yeah, we have to write the answer.
Which answer, sir? Answer students have to reply now. Students will revert the answer, and on the basis of answer, as a teacher you know the answer very well, what answer you are expecting from the student. On that basis you have created these rubrics, right? So on the basis of their response you are going to grade them, whether they deserve the excellent score or the good or fair or poor. Nice. With remarks, right? Am I clear, sir?
Okay,
thank you. Okay, so last topic, should I proceed to the next topic? That is the last one, how to create or how to conduct live classes using Google Meet. Should I proceed?
Okay, madam. Proceed, madam.
Okay, thank you. So there is one, till now, as of now, we have discussed about the study material, the post, how to make student to join the class, how to create the class. Everything was in passive mode. If we want to make the session interactive or we want to conduct the live class, then we have the option to create or to create a link using the Google Meet to conduct the live class. So what we need to do is, we just have to click Google Calendar. We just have to take the help of Google Calendar. It's for normal Gmail account. For G Suite, by default, Google Meet option is there. We can directly conduct a meeting or a live session using Google Meet. But as we are using the normal Gmail account, so we can use it with the help of Calendar. We can create a live class, but with the help of Calendar. So what we have to do, we just have to click Calendar. What we have to do is, we just have to create a session. We just have to click create. What we want, at what time we want. Suppose I am scheduling the live class from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. today itself, and I just have to click Google Meet conference. I just have to copy this Meet link. Please, professors, please make a note. I just have to click meeting link, save. An announcement. Dear students, please join the live class by clicking the link below. So this is the announcement I want to make. There are two options. You can paste the link here and add link. And secondly, you can paste the link over here also. Both way you can do. You can post it as a message or you can post it as a link as well. So I'm posting it both the ways. Now please check, I request you all to please check in your stream section you have you got this link or not. Let me see with student point of view also.
Yes, madam. Got it, madam.
Got it. Okay, thank you. So by this way, you can conduct live classes as well with the help of Google Meet. We need to do. Already we are in Google Meeting now, in this Google Meet. So I'm not going to click this. You just have to click it and you would be good to go to to join in this meeting. And you are ready to start the live class. So this is how a teacher can conduct live class with the help of Google Meet and Google Classroom. That is all about this session. I think we completed on time. Yeah. Okay, so just for a quick recap, I'm telling all the things verbally, what we did in this session. Well, we started from Google Classroom. First, we have to open the browser. The basic requirement for Google Classroom is just you have to have a Gmail account. That is all you have to have to go with the Google Classroom. You just have to open the browser, click classroom.google.com. You just have to log in with your Gmail ID, put your password, and you will be landed over to this page. After login, initially there would be no classes. You are going to create class. For creating the class, you just have to click this plus symbol. As a teacher, you are supposed to create class. So you just have to click create class and you can create the class. The class you are going to teach, you have to abide by the terms and conditions. So you just have to check this and continue. All right. Then you will be asked to create your class. Give the name, section, or the subject you are teaching. The room is optional, whether you want to give or not. Click OK. So your class would be created here. Many number of classes you can create with free account. I guess 100 classes you can create or you can join with your free Gmail account, and 30 classes per day. 250 participants can join a free Google Classroom with along with teachers. 20 teachers you can invite in for a single class. All right. So after creating the class, this interface you will get. This is student interface. In this you will get three tabs: stream, classwork, people. Let me show you the faculty, the teacher interface. This will be the interface for the faculty. Here you will get four ribbons: stream, classwork, people, grades. In stream section, you will have all your posts, whatever the announcement, the comments, class comments, your material, whatever activity you are going to perform, everything will be reflected here in chronological order. Means the newest thing will be at the top of the page. All the upcoming events would be here. Something, some assignment would be due or some quiz would be due. Everything would be displayed here. So you can view them by clicking view all. Right? Then the classwork tab. For the teacher point of view, this is the most important tab. You are going to do all the important work from this tab only. You are going to create your assignment with rubrics, without rubrics. You are going to create your quiz assignment. You can post question. You can post all the materials in the form of video, in the form of PDF form, PPT, or you can share it from Google. Am I audible to all of you? Just for testing purpose, I'm asking.
Yes, madam.
Okay, thank you. All right. So using this material tab, we can post all the material. Reuse post, we can use the same post with other classes as well. For topic creation, we can divide our whole course or structure in different topic-wise, unit-wise. So this is the main thing about this classwork. In people section, we have two options, teachers and students. If we create a class, then we would be at this portion. Single teacher would be there if you won't invite others. You can invite up to 20 teachers for free Google Classroom and up to 250 participants altogether in total. With teachers, there are two ways to invite students. First one, you can share the class code with the students, and class code you will get here from the dashboard. You just have to share this code with the student. They can directly join using this code. Second way, you can invite them by giving their mail IDs and you have to send them invite. Then they can join the class. So these are the two ways students and teachers can join. For teachers, you need to send specific invite. They can't join as a student because they are collaborators. So you need to send them specific invite. In grade section, whatever the assignment or quizzes you are posted will be reflected here. Right? You can see anytime. Okay, so that is all for today's session. I think, hello, Dr. Hema Kumar, sir. Should I end the session for now? Or you want to add something?
It's okay, the session.
Okay, so I request all the participants to reassemble at 1 p.m. sharp. We will start the next session at 1 p.m. Thank you all for your active participation.
Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I request Hema Kumar sir to end the meeting.